O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, hear my prayer.
And lift up thy heart to thee.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Graciously hear us, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, and vouchsafe to send thy holy angel from heaven to guard and cherish, to protect and visit, and to defend all who dwell in this thy holy habitation, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that we who through our ancient bondage are held beneath the yoke of sin, may by the new birth of thy only begotten Son in the flesh obtain deliverance through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
From the epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Hebrews. God, who at sundry times and in divers manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the Majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. For unto which of the angels said he at any time, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee? And yet I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. And again, when he bringeth in the first begotten into the world, he said, and let all the angels of God worship him. And of the angels he said, who maketh his angels spirits, and his ministers a flame of fire. But unto the Son he said, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore, God, even thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. And thou, Lord, in the beginning hast laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the works of thine hands. They shall perish, but thou remainest, and they all shall wax old as doth a garment, and as a vesture shalt thou fold them up, and they shall be changed. But thou art the same, and thy years shall not fail.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you,
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. A happy and merry Christmas to everyone. This is the third Mass of the Feast of the Nativity of our Lord. A few announcements for the good of the order. The first is refreshments after Mass are postponed. So not for this week and also not for next week. But if you need an orange, before you go, let me know. I think I know where a little stash is. Let us pray for all those who have asked our prayers or requested it for others. For Nikki, Chase, Bernice, Thelma, Ruth, Betty Jo, Harry, Crystal, Marie, Charles, Jason, Jonathan, Josephus, Celestina, Heather, Danny, Rodney, Zoltan, James, Danessa, Thomas, Sadie, Kevin, Patty, Leslie, Joanne, Mike, Dana, Jeff, Jen, Hildy, Andrew, Joyce, David, Clarice, Lorraine, Michael, Eddie, Maria, Nivia, Craig, Ty, Brandon, Yvette, Richard, Armando, Carlos, Marie-Claude, Mauricio, Richard, Natalie, Francis, Sally, Judith, Tony, Robert, Errol, Allison, Emily, Jennifer, Diane, Patricia, Courtney, Alberta, Kent, and Father Alton. And for those whose birthdays we celebrate this week, G. Harold Hosey and Ed Smith. And also we pray for the recently departed, John Maynard Trafton, Alma Wooden, Peter Carey, priest, June Ballard, Larry Long. And also for those whose death anniversaries we keep in the parish this week, Josephine Gertrude Byron, benefactress, Samuel Charles Borden, benefactor, Henry Clay Borden, benefactor, Anna Irene Ramage, benefactress, Elizabeth Jackson Baker, benefactress, Faye Gage, Frederick Sipes, Frederick Spees Penfold, priest and curate, Thomas Barclay Pritchett, benefactor, Gilbert Ramsey Underhill, priest and curate, William Hawks Longridge, priest of the Society of St. John the Evangelist, priest and curate, Sister Bernadine, Society of the Holy Nativity, or Sisters of the Holy Nativity, William Elwell, priest and rector, William Stanley Musselman, priest, Margaret Lewis Benjamin, benefactress, and Lawrence Fisher. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Through the mystery of the Word made flesh, the light of thy glory hath shone anew upon the eyes of our mind. This from the solemn preface of the Nativity. And here we have gathered together in the fullness of midday to be caught up, to be raptured in love, a light beyond all brightness. On this day, many families and religious communities are gathered, and folks who are away from their loved ones will no doubt exercise their great power of memory and affection in their observance, if not celebration, of Christmas. And for many of us, there will be an exchange of gifts, not because we have been bad or good, which is really an imposter to Christmas, because God's gift of God's own self in the incarnation is so completely unmerited and incomprehensible, we just simply hardly know what to do but to give and receive and to stir our hearts with festivities. And yet, whether we are gathered or in solitude, whether we have gifts to share or are destitute, we have been given that which is closer to us than consciousness itself. We have been invited into a love that is utterly unfazed by our limitations and self-clutching. Even as we can get wrapped up in clinging to ourselves, yet in each of us, deep in the bottom of the soul, there is a groundless openness that does not deal in images or sounds or words. It is in fact deeper than self-reflection and deeper than any knowing, be it human or angelic. It is here that God gives birth in the soul. It's a kind of uncanny manger for Christ, not wrapped in bands of cloth, but pervading our being and all the whole wide world. Christmas is often thought of as a great feast of fullness. I know I have plenty of images of a full table. Remember my grandparents, and of course my parents, everybody all around, kids, grandkids, neighbors, dogs, cats, farm animals that aren't supposed to be in the house at times. And yet, I recognize the images of family and home and hearth, as wonderful and as stressful as they can be, are not the image of our Lord's birth, minus the farm animals. Notice that the Holy Family is on the margins of society and their own culture. They are under the Roman occupation. Our Lady traveled 80 miles by foot or donkey uphill to Bethlehem, where Jesus was born in the lower room of a house, what we would consider the barn, because there was no room in the upper room or the quote-unquote inn. And there, placed in a manger, a trough for beasts' food. And so this is not a scene of home and hearth. It is a fullness of prophecy, of miracle, and of great humility. And so as I wonder about how wonderful it is to be with family and friends and to be surrounded by those who care about you and who you too care about, I sense this great support, a great support to our spiritual life and our Christian practice in general. We have all this love. We have such an opportunity to not leave Christmas at the level of the senses, to not leave Christmas to the wonders of memory or knowing, or even our desires fulfilled or not, but to be supported by all that wonder of Christmas so that we might get caught up in the mystery of the Word made flesh. Christmas is a celebration of more than what can be accomplished with the senses, with our interior faculties, with science, with anything, let alone what we could buy or get or even enjoy. And we are now here in the third Mass of Christmas. It's a sort of culmination of the three masses of this feast, the three births of Christ. In the darkness of night, we celebrated the first of the triple birth. That is, Christ begotten before all worlds, natum ante omnia saecula. In that humble, that essential manger of divine darkness, hence it's in the middle of the night, and in ancient times on the darkest day of the year. This morning at daybreak, when darkness and light met, we celebrated the second of the triple birth, that is Christ born, ex Maria Virgine, and was made man, born of the Virgin Mary, and found swaddled and lying in a manger in Bethlehem, the second birth. And now here we are in the third, midday. I would say the full blast of sun, but it's kind of cloudy out today. We're celebrating the birth of the Word in the soul. Though it might as easily be said that through grace we are being born of God, as our gospel today says, not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. In pointing to what the incarnation is about, St. Athanasian says famously and rather plainly, God became man, that man might become God. That through the overabundant generosity of God, we are invited to be caught up and born of God. In this overabundance, we are given the invitation to be born of God and through grace realize the intimacy of being God's child. An intimacy that is in and through Christ, so intimate that human beings have struggled to articulate this. Hence, perhaps, the three masses of this one feast. And so as we gather together during these 12 days of Christmas, we might begin with a natural affection for the baby Jesus. Even a simple meditation on the child in the manger can be of great assistance to stir the heart, to gather the senses. St. Francis of Assisi famously commended a special devotion to the nativity scene, and so for many a visit to the creche is of such assistance. For some of us, a few rounds of O Come All Ye Faithful, or maybe you're into God Rest You Merry Gentlemen, or Once in Royal David's City, a few rounds of this might stir the spirit, stir the heart, quicken the blood. And during these 12 days, you might approach this first birth of the Word in divine darkness. And I offer this simple meditation on God to bring your inquiring faith to a point. Who is this whose center is everywhere and whose circumference is nowhere? Let yourself be gathered into a single spark of penetrating wonder, peering out at the edge of your mind, whose center is everywhere and whose circumference is nowhere. Who is this God? Get to the bottom of this birth. You may be, in fact, drawn to a more direct path of surrendering your very being to God in the humility of identification with Christ, in that deep openness of the soul. Blessed Johannes Tauler of the 14th century commending this direct route, in the measure in which a person surrenders themselves and turns to that inmost ground, grace is born in the highest way. Let us take this wonderful opportunity of support to enter into our celebration of Christmas as the mystery of the Word made flesh continues to unfold throughout our bodies and minds, throughout the world, the very sacrament of reality. O God, make speed to enlighten the eyes of our mind. Amen.
Thank you.
hath shone anew upon the eyes of our mind, that as we acknowledge God made visible to man, we may through him be caught up to love of things invisible, and therefore with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominations, and with all the company of the heavenly hosts, we sing the majesty of thy glory evermore, praising thee and saying,
thank you.
to us sinners also. Throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your
thank you.
take away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not
thank you. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that like as thy Son born this day, Savior of the world, is the author of our heavenly birth, so he may likewise bestow on us the gift of everlasting life, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. Behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. When he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, Bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, They saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord brought tidings unto Mary.
As she conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
He helps me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Resurrection through the same Christ our Lord.